Okay, so you're a stable multivibrator. As we discussed, there is no external trigger pulse which is required to switch over from on to off and off to on state. So this a stable multivibrator is also called as free running multivibrator. That is because it without any external trigger pulse, it can switch over from on to off and off to on. So it is called as free running multivibrator. This a stable multivibrator, the output, if you see the stable multivibrator of output, it gives you square wave output. So wherever the applications of square wave is required, there you can use your a stable multivibrator. So as we discussed, RA, RB and C decides on the on time and off time, which is connected externally to your 555 timer circuit. Okay, so if you see in this diagram, this is how your block diagram of your stable multivibrator looks like. You have pin number 4. So pin number 4, which is the reset pin. So that is connected to your VCC. So this provides resetting of your entire timer circuit. Okay, but usually we don't use it. That's the reason we have connected it to VCC. So when we connect it to VCC, what happens is this avoids false resetting of your circuit. And similarly, you have pin number 5, which is connected wherein a capacitor is connected to your pin number 5. So your pin number 5 is your control voltage pin. This is connected externally with a capacitor of 0.01 microfarad. That is because we don't usually this pin also, we are not using it. We don't use this control voltage pin. And that is the reason we have to connect a capacitor externally so that noise which are present in this terminal would be eliminated. Okay, with the help of this through the capacitor. Okay. And also a false triggering of the circuit can be avoided by connecting a capacitor to it. So purpose of connecting the capacitor would be either you can eliminate the noise and or you can avoid the false triggering of the circuit. So that is the reason you connect a capacitor between pin number 5 and ground. Next is your pin number 6. So your pin number 6, 7 and 2. So one pin number 6 would be your threshold and 7 is discharge and 2 is your trigger. So if you see, these are connected, your discharge and threshold pin is connected with the trigger pulse. Now, so as we discussed before, trigger pulse is not applied here. That's the reason it is connected to VCC. So from 2, it goes to VCC. 2, 6 and 7, which is connected. And your 2, since we are not using it, it is connected to VCC through your RA and RB. So this is about your pin diagrams of your a stable multivibrator. Since we are not using any trigger pulse here, so we should consider two waveforms. Okay, so one is your voltage across capacitor and output voltage. Okay, so but whereas in your monostable, we used to consider trigger pulse. Okay, trigger pulse waveform we used to consider, and then capacitor voltage, then output waveform we used to consider in monostable. Whereas in a stable multivibrator, you have only capacitor voltage which we are considering and output voltage. Okay, so only these are the two waveforms which we have to consider. Your voltage across your capacitor. Okay, so voltage across your capacitor and VC. Would be considered, and your pin number 3, which is your output voltage across your Q dash, which is RS from the RS flip flop. Okay, and now what happens is charging and discharging of capacitor would give you output waveform. Okay, so So which waveform it gives? It gives the variable pulse width. Okay, so which decides your on time and off time. Is it clear? Your charging and discharging of the capacitor, as seen in the waveform, charging and discharging of the capacitor would give you your output waveform, which is your variable pulse width. This decides your on time and off time. And now let us see here. See, we have different time intervals. We'll see first. Okay, during your on time, or we can also say the interval between 0 to T1. Okay, we should understand what happens to your timer circuit. So when you see in this waveform, you can see that charging of the capacitor, which is happening through RA and RB. Okay, and when there is charging of the capacitor voltage, what happens? Your output voltage is going to high state. Okay, that is happening during your on time. Okay, let us go to the circuit now. Okay, we see here comparators, RS flip-flop and capacitor, RA, RB and a transistor. Okay, so what happens here is, initially when we see in the waveform, the capacitor voltage, it is zero, correct? So initially it is zero. So because of this VC zero, what happens is the voltage across pin 2 and pin number 6 would also be zero. Okay, so as one of the output of your lower comparator is zero, this is nothing but it is less than 1/3 of VCC. So because of that, what will happen? The lower comparator, which is your comparator 2, would go to on state. So when this comparator 2 goes to high, what happens? The SR flip-flop would be reset. Okay. When SR flip-flop is reset, what will happen? Q will become 0 and Q dash or Q complement is going to be 1. So since Q dash is 1, the output voltage would be your high. Okay. Since your Q is 0, what will happen? The Q is 0, which is connected to your transistor. So this transistor would, since it is zero, so this would drive transistor to go to off state or to cutoff region or to open switch. So because of that, what will happen? Charging of the capacitor would take place. Okay, so charging of the capacitor would take place through the your RA and RB, through the resistor RA and RB, through your towards the VCC. Okay, and this capacitor starts to charge exponentially and it charges up to 2/3 of VCC. If you see here in the waveform, it is written it charges the peak of the charging capacitor, it is 2/3 of VCC. Okay, so it charges till then, and during this time what will happen? As we discussed, the output voltage is going to be high, so that's where the on time is going to be higher. Okay, that gives you, that represents Q dash. Well, your off state, or we can say TD. So during this TD, or between the interval T1 to T2, let us see what is happening in your circuit diagram. So during this time, what will happen? Your output of the comparator 1 goes high. Okay, so your comparator 1 goes high. That is because your pin number 6 has high voltage than your 2/3 of VCC. So if you see at this point, the charging of the capacitor has stopped at 2/3 of VCC. So so above this voltage, so above this voltage, your threshold pin or pin number 6 has high voltage than 2/3 of VCC. That is because of your, that is because of that, your comparator 1 goes to high state. When comparator 1 goes to high state, what will happen? There would be setting of your RS flip-flop would take place. So RS flip flop would be set. So because of that, what will happen? Q will become high at this point, whereas Q dash is going to be zero. That is the reason output voltage is low at this interval. And Q is one. So because of that, transistor QD would be drive into saturation state. Okay, so this acts like a closed switch. So when this acts like a closed switch, what will happen? Capacitor starts to discharge through your RB and your transistor. Okay, through this, it starts to discharge. And so till where it discharges up to 1/3 of VCC. If you see in the waveform, you can clearly see that there is discharging of the capacitor till up to 1/3 of VCC. Okay, so this is your off time of your, so this is what you call it as off time, wherein capacitor starts to discharge through the resistor RB. Okay, so total time you can consider it as on time and off time. Okay, so one cycle we will consider it as on time and off time. So which is nothing but T on, see, if you see in this equation, time for one cycle would be considered as, that is third bulletin, if you see, T is equal to TC plus TD, where TC is your charging time and TD is your discharging time of the capacitor. Okay, so frequency is written as F is equal to 1 by T. So T is nothing but your sum of TC plus TD. Okay, and on time can be written as, or the charging time of the capacitor can be written as 0.693 into, since during your charging time you have RA and RB and capacitor. So since these three elements are coming into, or these three components are coming into picture, so during charging time you will consider the equation as 0.693 into RA plus RB into C. Whereas during your discharging time, you consider 0.693 into, during discharging time, there is only resistor RB which is coming into picture. So RB into C coming into place. So one cycle is written as TC plus TD. When you sum these two, you would get it as 0.693 into RA plus 2RB into C. This is your total time. Okay. So this total time, when you substitute in the frequency, that is F. So when you substitute here, you will obtain it as F is equal to, you know that T you have already obtained. And F is equal to 1 by T. When you do that, you get it as F is equal to 1.44. RA plus 2RB into C hertz. Okay, this is your frequency and the total time. Now what is this duty cycle? Duty cycle is written as, you know that it is a duty cycle is nothing but on time divided by T, total time. So where W is represented as on time, whereas, or you can also represent it as TC, okay, divided by T is your total time. So T is nothing but T.